Hey, it's 9:10 a.m. February 8th, February 2017, Wednesday. So, this is how I look. And I'm just, I feel like my chest is so big. It's like, I don't know, I wish I could just lose some weight. It's like, I didn't have my breakfast, so, but today my weight was 65.1. Yesterday it was 64.5. But look, I'm wearing a bra, and on top of that, I'm wearing this kind of singlet type thing. Because I was thinking of wearing this t-shirt on top. So, you know, it's like, I just feel like my shoulders are just way too big. It's like, it's like, yes, my tummy is a bit. It's like, I just want to, I was so desperately want to lose weight. Yesterday, I didn't have my veggie stew. So yesterday, my weight was 64.5, which was good, but then today 65.1 because I had an extra soy latte and I had like this puttu thing, this Sri Lankan dish, but it's, you know, I didn't have the veggie stew, so it's like, wasn't my shoulders like, I don't know, it's like in proportion, you know, it's like I don't know, it's like, oh, I look. Well, I feel, just how my body looks there. So, I mean, it's not like, when you see it from that far, I mean, it's not like my shoulders are huge in comparison, you know, to my. But I am getting a bit of hips, like, you know, these are. You know. So, you know, it's like. That's all right. So, yeah, it's not too bad, but sometimes I feel like, you know, yeah, so it's like I'm getting hips and stuff, but so I'm happy with that. But sometimes when I look like that, it's like, holy shit. And yeah, the reason I'm wearing this thing is under, you know, because this is like a see-through. You can actually see through the. So I thought I'll wear this kind of thing on top of it. So, oh, look at my muscles. Oh my god, that actually my muscles used to be much bigger than this. They used to be like, oh shit, that was like, so I do have a bit of an athletic build. I remember I used to go to the gym and it's like, the thing with this bra thing is like they really, like I don't have my breasts aren't that big, so it just tends to crush it in like that. I don't know, but you can tell, you know, I've got breasts, so you can tell. So, and I'm happy, but you know, sometimes I just feel like it just. Anyway, so. So I was thinking about these kinds of things. Thinking about a scary thing. I've got to go to the, what do I have to go to? I've got to go to the job agency today. I have an appointment at 10:30. What is going to happen in this appointment? What is going to happen? What is gonna happen? What's gonna happen? I've got one of these things and it's like, it's, I really need to get the stuff I really need. I actually ordered some more. I need to shave and I see like how my armpits is like, it's like, it doesn't look nice. Jesus, I haven't shaved in like, oh my god. God, I've gotta like, I don't know, do some like, put lime or something in there because it looks like the skin is a bit darker there, and I don't like that. So I don't know. These days, like everyone, like people, are like you've seen the magazines, it's like, oh, it's like everything has to be so perfect, or you know, you just go. Anyway, I did order some movies, Blu-ray movies. They shipped it. So I ordered six because they were selling three movies for $20. So I ordered six movies. So I got Brokeback Mountain. I haven't seen that. Spring Breakers. This is I really like this film. I think it's made by the same guy who made Kids. You know, so it's got this very, it's about these, you know, these uni students in America who go to this party or something, but it's I don't know, the funny thing about this movie is, but there is no actual sex scenes in this, but it's sort of, but you would think that that's what this movie is about, but no, the movie is actually much more of a smart movie, and it's got a very interesting dialogue, and I like that film. And then I got Seven. I got The Ring. I actually have The Ring on DVD, but I want The Ring Blu-ray, so all of these are Blu-rays. And I also got the Piano on Blu-ray, and also Betty Blue. I have Betty Blue on DVD. And Betty Blue. But I want to get the Blu-ray version. It's about this. It's an old film. It's like 1970 something. So if I can read it, it's a pretty old film, 1970 something. It's 178 minutes, pretty long. So Zorg is a handyman working at the French Riviera, maintaining and looking after the bungalows. He lives a quiet and peaceful life, working diligently and writing in his spare time. One day, Betty walks into his life, a young woman who is as beautiful as she is wild and unpredictable. After a dispute with Zorg's boss, they leave, and Betty manages to get a job at a restaurant. She persuades Zorg to try and get one of his books published, but it is rejected, which makes Betty fly into a rage. Suddenly, Betty's wild manners start to get out of control. Zorg sees the woman he loves slowly going insane. Can his love prevail, even if it comes to the worst? At last, the legendary three-hour director's cut by Jacques Bayneau, I don't know, of his romantic masterpiece, Betty Blue, has arrived on DVD, expanding dramatically on the adventures of Betty and Zorg, and Betty's journey from kooky to crazy. The director's cut introduces several new scenes. Yeah, like, so she tends to go a little bit more and more crazy. Oh, so it's in 1986, not 70, 1986. But at the end of the movie, you think he's the one who's crazy because but he's actually in love with her, but she's actually going crazy. So anyway, so yes, okay. I don't know, my shoulders look so big. My neck, anyway, I'm getting way too obsessed about that. But you know, I'm happy with my transition. I'm happy with the changes. I'm very, very happy with it. I'm quite pleased. I just want to lose weight, you know, so my, you know, some of these, like, it's not really that bad, you know, okay, that's all right, I look a bit athletic, it's all right, you know, lots of women look athletic, but, well, that's all right. I just want to lose some weight, so just a little bit of touch up, you know, so. Wait a minute, I'm supposed to do my makeup. Holy shit, wait, I'll stop this. Yeah, I'll start recording again. Okay, so it's 9:20 a.m. I think I should put this on because I don't want to put this on after I put my makeup on. So I will put this on. I have to go to the job agency. This is size 14, Australia. So that should be size 10 US, I think. I don't know. So see, as you can see, this is like a see-through thing. See? So because it's see-through, I wanted to wear something underneath. So that's what I had in, that's what my thinking on this. Oh, wait a minute. What's this? Oh, I'm tired. I did shaving. I noticed that on this side. And then shaving, it really hurt because I think I've got some skin like issues here. Like, I don't know what that is. It's like eczema, maybe? I don't know. It's very sensitive. Unfortunately, I did not wash the. Let me put a different color background so the light reflects back. Ah! Yeah, see the difference? Oh, there's not much light, but then... Oh, there's some light. Oh, that makes so much of a difference. Should make an appointment to see the electrolysis. Oh, great, but too much. Too much. Oh, shit. That's way too much. Way too much. Have to struggle with this damn thing. Oh my god. Oh, I keep on forgetting. It's like my 3-year mark on HRT was on the 6th of February. I wanted to do a Tumblr kind of post because I did that for 1 year and 2 years. So my 3-year mark on HRT, could have done a video on that, but I didn't. It was on February 6th or something, because I think I started on February 6th. 2014, so 2014, 15, 16, yeah, that's three years. That's a milestone of sorts. Yes. So I will try and get to that Tumblr post. I keep on forgetting. Oh, your skin is sensitive there. Oh, it's sensitive. Maybe I've got to, I've got to take care of my skin. And shoes. Change my pillow covers. Maybe they're like, they got toxins in it or something. Toxins. Yes. I wasn't actually preparing, planning to record. No, I wanted to record. Oh, I don't know, maybe 9:30. But I started early. I started early. So you might as well do it now. You can see the sun rays, see the ray of sunlight. Yeah, that looks kind of eerie. It looks eerie. Reminds me of that TV show, Eerie Indiana. Do you remember watching that as a kid? Eerie Indiana. Yes, childhood. Sometimes your childhood is where it all starts. All your problems start there. Wonder if this is okay. I don't know. I just like, I feel like I look too masculine. I feel like I look way too masculine. Something about my face. I don't know. Maybe it's in my head. Yeah. I'm a bit tired. I don't know, I feel everyone feel like it. I don't know what is it, but something about my face, it looks masculine. My makeup isn't working. So what, I am a trans person, trans woman, so it's alright. Man, society, man, it's just, I don't experience as much discrimination going on, but imagine if you're visibly trans, you know how much discrimination you're gonna face and walking in the street, you know how bad it's gonna be. You're just gonna be harassed, and it's just the worst. I'm scared enough, like I'm so conscious, self-conscious, like I tend to sort of blend in, but I still feel like my face. I feel like this kind of not very bright, positive. So that's kind of sucky. I don't know what to expect at this job search thing. I don't know what is going on. So I guess I'll figure it out when I get there or whatever. Yeah, I'm just very tired. I am tired. I get exhausted like so easily. Like my moods are like so fluctuating. They be fluctuating a lot. Still haven't gone to my GP. One day if I get. In trouble for that. But this hairstyle is just like, I gotta have a better hairstyle. Jesus. So I feel like, Anyway, so it's 9:30. I am tired. I look all right there. That looks nice. That looks all right. I look like a girl. Like, now I get the hair down. I'm looking in the mirror. I don't know. There's something about this stupid thing. There's something weird about it. But oh, that looks nice. Yeah. That sort of helps my confidence, allays my anxiety. So I guess that's why I was feeling low, because I thought I look a bit too masculine and I was feeling a bit low. I was like, oh no, I don't want to look like that. But now when I look in the mirror and oh, I look feminine, I look like a girl, so I can pass. So it allays my anxiety and gives me self-confidence. So I feel better. So my mood went down because I felt like I looked masculine. But then now when I look in the mirror, I look feminine, and then my mood went up again. So my mood goes up and down depending on my perceptions or what's happening in the external world or what I'm dealing with. Anyway, I will probably make clips going out, and so it's 11:32 p.m. So I look. Yes, it is what you look like. You better go now. This is the front view. I had to put a little bit more of it. Put a little more of makeup on my thing. Raining. It's a rainy day. It's a wet, rainy day. I hope I have the umbrella. Yeah, the phone there go. Umbrella. I asked my mom if she has the phone. She said, so it's 11:59. I just got out of the interview. Oh, such a long thing. No, because I had a one-to-one session with her. I have to go there tomorrow as well. She's trying to get me into some kind of a call center job. So. To go tomorrow and give a copy of my give my referees and bring my citizenship certificate so she can make a copy of that. And so this is a pretty long. Oh my god, my forehead. Oh, my poor mother. She's been waiting to pick me up. I didn't think it would go this long, and I don't think it's gonna be normally like this, but because this is the first like time it took longer. So
get head home. So I'm sitting in the car. It's some few minutes after 12. I didn't think it would take this long, but it did. So if I get this call center job, that would be good. I could make some money. Yeah, you know, we talked about the legal stuff, but anyway, the thing is, you just get a job and get some experience, you know, make some money and get in the habit. Then I'll know what I really want to do. But first, I have to do this job. Guy. This guy was in the car next. I've got lots of pimples. I'm a very quiet person. In my videos and stuff, I rant a lot and I complain and yell. But in real life, I'm very quiet and I'm very non-confrontational. I'm very, I'm an easy person to get along with. Probably because I don't really talk that much. So I'm probably like one of those quiet people. People you don't notice. See, I have a YouTube channel because it's like my outlet. It's my way of being seen and heard, because in real life I am quite invisible. The contrast between how I am in real life and how I am in my YouTube videos, it's very dramatic, because in real life I'm like a invisible. I don't talk to people. I just mind my own business, do whatever, so I'm a very quiet person. So my YouTube is a way of compensating for my very shy demeanor, you know. It's very, very different. That's something you guys should know. Whoever's watching. So, no, I feel kind of good because she was like telling me, I just didn't like there was one part where I just didn't like. She thought that, and I said I had mental health issues, and she was like acting like, if you sabotage the interview, I can cancel your payment. I'm like, please, why are you talking to me like this? I'm not trying to. I wasn't confrontational. I was just very quiet, and I was like, I just found that a bit like, okay, you know. Fine, I guess she's just saying what she needs to say, but it's like so heartless, man. So heartless. See, now in my videos, I'm complaining and bitching, but I didn't complain to her. So I'll be going tomorrow as well. I just have to hand over my references and my certificate, because the thing is, like, I could have given my I had I gave it for my driver's license and my Medicare, but I had my bank card with me. But on my bank card, that stupid Commonwealth Bank, they wouldn't change my gender, and on the name it's put M, Mr. Yvette Sati. I'm like, fuck, I'm not gonna show that. I've been trying to get them to change it, and they want me to. Anyway, I have to get that stupid gender recognition certificate. This is a problem when you're trans. It's like, so I'll bring my citizenship certificate because that automatically gives me like 75 points or something. I need 100 points. My driver's license is 40 points, so if I just bring my citizenship certificate, I would auto, you know, I don't need to bring anything more, but. So another trans problem. No, she doesn't know I'm trans, so it's interesting. That's good. Anyway, so whatever, you know, I apparently tomorrow I'll bring the stuff, and then they will put me into the system, and then I will have an appointment with this lady who works there, who's like a marketing person for the center. So I will have an appointment with her, and she will evaluate me to determine if I am suitable for this position, this call center position. And then if she thinks I'm suitable, she will refer me to the employer, and then I will have an interview with the employer, and then if I get the job, then I'll have to go to some kind of a 3-day training course, which is paid for by my employment agency. It's like $875 or something. And so basically, tomorrow I'm going to give my documents, and then I'll have an interview or appointment with this lady who works there. And then she will determine if I'm suitable or not. And then if she thinks I am, I get to have an appointment with the employer. And then if I'm successful with them, then, you know, it's like I can start working on March 14th or something. So there are all these steps to follow. So she wanted two references. I can give a reference to my principal solicitor. I can also give a reference to the other legal place I worked, but I only worked there for a few days. So I'm thinking of also giving a reference to, like, in Marrickville Legal Center, the principal solicitor there might know me because my principal solicitor at the Inner City Legal Center and the principal solicitor at Marrickville, they know each other and they've talked about me. And actually, when my principal solicitor did the character reference for me, he actually had the other principal solicitor witness the document. So they did talk about me. They did read the not the character reference, the what do you call that? The character reference where I talk about my history, where I was, you know, my criminal behavior, which I disclosed to the Legal Profession Admission Board. So they must have had a discussion about that. So she might know me because I did apply for a position there, and I did work there for a couple of days. So maybe I'll use her as my second referee or third referee. So anyway, so I gotta go in tomorrow. So I am a bit tired now. Yes, you see, if I bring my look at how it sort of distorts my face, but if I think it's not that bad there, yeah. Yeah, anyway, it's raining. It is raining. It is raining. So it's 1 p.m. Oh, it just turned 1:01 p.m. I'm back from the exhausting day out. I just thought I'll talk a little bit about four of those movies got delivered.
So yeah, about this job thing about the at the call center. Yeah, well, I'd like to, well, I'd like to go to the interview at least, and that might be interesting. So, you know, I have my mental health issues, but I want to try and get a job anyway. You know, anyway. Yeah, so this is movie 7. Brad Pitt, Morgan Freeman. Oh, Brokeback Mountain. I still haven't seen this. Isn't this about these two guys are like gay or something? I don't know. I haven't seen this. The Ring. I have The Ring and The Ring 2 on DVD, but this is a Blu-ray. I like this film. Yeah, Naomi Watts, the cool actress. I think the first one of the first movies I saw about her was this film called Gross Misconduct, and she was like some kind of an abused, sexually abused girl. I think her dad abused her, and then she had a relationship with this with her college professor or something, who was Jimmy Smith, I think. So that was the movie I saw, and she I think she also acted in that Ira Einhorn, the Unicorn Killer, wasn't it her? I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, she's a good actress, Australian actress. Yeah. Right, this is the movie Spring Breakers, and see, James DeFranco, he does a very good performance in this movie. He's a gangster. Don't know. This is a funny movie. It's actually quite intelligent, the for a subject which seems so unintelligent, you know, spring break, and you know, it's actually quite entertaining, and oh, it's directed by Harmony Korine. Harmony, that guy's a good director. I think he wrote the script for Kids. I don't think he directed Kids, but Harmony Korine. Anyway, so this movie. The piano and Betty Blue, they were shipped separately because apparently they were like on a different shipping schedule or something. Yeah, I have to edit the video and all that. I don't know how. I want to do it in a relaxed fashion, and I don't want to rush things. So it's 1:04 p.m. now. I want to get something to eat. Maybe have another soy latte. And yeah, do it really in a, I don't know. I'll do the edits maybe around 2:30. Yeah, just a bit. Oh, this might be a long video. So anyway. Yeah. All right. All right, talk later. Yeah.